Alright, today I'm going to start working on some additional details. So the first one I'm going to work is closing up the front of this. So it's the perfect height that I can use my 1-inch C that's left over from my frame rails. So let's just mark it for cutting width. And I will cut this blue line. Do after that, I think I'll put some panels across here. Maybe put a couple screws on each one, and that way these are, if you hadn't noticed, I'm missing a couple pieces of frame right in here. And the reason being is that's where I'm gonna put the electronics for the lights and the battery and stuff. So that being said, I'll need some kind of cover plate and access to it. So I'll probably do that after this. All right, so width-wise it fits in there, but now I need to trim a little bit off of this bottom edge. That's ready to weld in. Bottom right, outboard. Bottom left, outboard. Alright, now I'm gonna drill and tap these little panels. So, first thing, let's get a Sharpie here. Let's mark the spot. So this is the bottom right and outboard. Alright, bottom left, outboard. Now these aren't that critical. I just want to make sure that I hit those flanges that I put in there. Then I shouldn't need any cutting oil. Just run right through. Time to cut some screws. Cutting some screws. Suppose I'll finish this after my lunch. I'm gonna go for a quick bike ride. Let's take the boring one today so I can haul ass. Ready? And lunchtime. All right, time to finish these screws up. All right, bottom left outboard.
canceled the rest of the year. Can we get one of those diplomas you were gonna hand out?
All right. Alright, so that's where my light controllers and battery can go for that. I need to figure out up here what we got going on here. So this is the battery that's going to go in there. Can't go that way, so it's going to have to go like this. And I've also got this BEC. And this receiver here to figure out. So probably won't need the remote receiver for this. This is just one to increase your signal. You can put it somewhere else, so that way you got double the receivers, essentially covering a bigger area, so it doesn't need to be as strong of a signal. Well, I can use it if I need to, so I won't get rid of it. Alright, and now this obviously doesn't need to be this long. Those wires are going to take up lots of space. So let's shorten this one down considerably. And then same with this one, we'll shorten it down considerably as well. But I do suppose first I should make sure that this radio will work as intended before I cut and modify and mount everything up, huh? So. Alright, now let's get into this truck so I can get that receiver, bind the two at the same time, and make them twinsies that'll work together. I think I'm gonna turn that heater off here soon, one of these days. Don't seem to need it. It's been in the 80s, I think, the last couple days, maybe. It was chilly for a little bit, but then it just, boom, said, hey, it's summer. This life. I think I'm gonna do a couple things while I'm in the truck here today. We'll see. I think I'm gonna get rid of the little switch on here that makes it go click and make the noise, and just plug the plug into itself, so I just have full power all the time, and it'll hook to the trailer easier because it won't have to push that little thing. And I think the nuts on the bottom of the front axle, I'm gonna try and flip those U-joints or something, because as it is right now, those nuts catch on everything. There's only like an eighth inch or so between the ground and the nuts on the bottom of this front axle, so might be time to do something about that. Oh no, wires tangled everywhere. There we go. There we go, mate. Need that guy. Alright, so let's get some binding action going. Get him plugged in there. Plugged in the wrong one. All right, let's try this again. All right. Now they should be twins. Let's take the bind plugs out. Now the bind plugs are out. Now let's turn them off. Now let's find out if that worked. I don't remember which switches were which. Look at that, one radio, both independently. How cool is that? So my theory works. So I got that set up, so it does work, so I can start chopping wires and running stuff. But while I have this guy open, there's a few things I want to do. Like I said, I think I'm going to get rid of the little hook that makes it go clunk clunk. So I'll always be able to fix this later. Alright, now it'll always be full power like there's a trailer engaged. Let's get this back together before I lose everything. Now I don't think I'll make the thing right now for this, but what I am going to do is mark my holes. Alright, what else did I want to do back here? That might be it for the back here. Alright. Now, on the front, what I was talking about is those acorn nuts. Look at how low they are. I'd get a quarter inch if I could flip those beams over. I don't know if I can, but if I can, I can get a quarter inch. I really like these little scale U bolts, but they drag on everything. I'll do one at a time so I don't mess up my alignment. Alright, so this is going to stay on the bottom. I'll make one that mirrors it for the other side. And then I'll put probably the screws I cut off all and wasted. Let's see if these ones will be long enough. Yeah, the ones I said I never use are probably the ones I need now. Oh, those will work, but just. Alright, let's do it to that side now. Alright. Now you can look under there. I've actually got some ground clearance. So, right here, those nuts were the lowest point, and the screw heads still are, but they're a little higher than before. Alright, so I bent up some of these little tabs here. The idea is I'm gonna weld them in there, and that way I can tuck the servo wire in there and it'll hold it. Alright, so I got this routed so it has some play to go back out. I got it tucked up inside my little clips, except for this last one here. I gotta make a hole for this to go through. Alright, so that'll end up going in there. That'll end up going in there. So that'll pretty much all hang out right there inside the neck. Alright, so that'll pretty much all end up going in there. I could just make a flat plate, but I don't want to. I want something that's gonna look decent and not just be a smooth flat plate. So, you know, there's different stuff they have in here, so I might make a flat plate that sits down in there and then build some detail on it to make it look like you got your little generator and hydro pump here and all your connections and stuff that would be in here. I might try and do all that. But for today, that is it. So didn't get a whole lot done. Did a lot of little stuff. I got the truck so it rides, has some ground clearance and doesn't get stuck, while I removed the little switch from there and gave the truck full power. And the whole reason I even did that was so I could bind this new receiver at the same time as that one. So the two receivers were twin skis, so both work off of this at the same time without switching models or anything. So this works off of channel number 6 with its own receiver, and that runs off of the other 5. So there we go, we got a thing now. Now I got my little brackets in here to tuck all the wire. I left a little hanging down so it can pull more as it needs to go backward more. And I got my little plates in here that'll screw on to cover my wireless light controller and stuff for the trailer lights. So, this being said, that is it for today. So, hope you enjoyed. See you next time.